Hey, welcome to the Danger Zone. It's Ashley. Everything in my video was found on a public domain. Lots of love and many blessings your way. I knew I had seen that look that Meghan's trying to pull off somewhere before. You guys, she cannot be herself. She is so trying too hard to be Princess Diana. Oh, Lord. Okay, so the big story was the reunification of Prince William and Kate and Harry and Meghan during the Remembrance Festival at Albert Hall. I wonder if it makes them feel a certain way that they're not being spoken to by the family, not in public, not behind closed doors. Let me show you the slick trick that they tried to pass off as a reunion between the brothers and their wives. First off, check out how far apart they were in the balcony. Kate and William were just about front and center, while Harry and Meghan were stashed in the back in the nosebleed section. Their games are just over the top ridiculous. Even on their Instagram, they're talking about reunion between the brothers as they share this picture. They took two pictures and shoved them together, trying to make it look like they're all in the same area together. Why can't they just be honest and say we didn't sit next to each other and we didn't talk? You guys need to caption this photo down in the comments. I so wish I knew what they were talking about, but I have a feeling. Everybody's up in arms over the fact that Meghan seems to be given the signal that she's yet again carrying another moon bump. Doesn't Harry look as if somebody told him, hey, look, your e-tron out in the driveway just got totaled. Could he be any more depressed? Anyway, so as it was told to me yesterday, Harry will not be joining Meghan right away in LA. There's been a big change of plans. It seems that the Queen has put him on an assignment for the 17th of November. So it was told to me that this was meant to be their last event before they took off to LA, but it seems the family has a different plan in mind. I was told that they are deliberately separating Harry and Meghan so they could have a sit down with Harry. And did you guys know that they forced Meghan to walk behind Harry at the Field of Remembrance? It's about time she follows a rule. Everybody's talking about this latest trend that Meghan's all about. She seems to never leave the house without a glob of lash glue stuck in her eyes. As a cosmetologist esthetician by trade, let me share with you this. All that is, it's a result of not cleaning your face well enough before you put another application of lash glue on. And I have severe hygiene hangups. I'm not kidding. There's a couple of things on a woman I look at. How well she keeps her skin and how well she keeps her feet. I can tell you as a woman, if you're neglecting your feet and your skin, you cannot possibly be taking care of other important areas of your body. Just my opinion. Yuck. Okay, you guys, for the longest time, I've really teetered on whether or not Samantha and Thomas were in on everything. And after watching Samantha's latest interview, I'm convinced they are not in on nothing. She's felt extremely unsafe because people have been allowed to give her death threats, make all sorts of posters and gifts and memes threatening her, and that can be scary, especially in her condition. And I can almost tell you from my own experience since having this channel that I do believe these may be paid participants. I myself have recently had a death threat. And after I looked this person up, my jaw hit the ground. Really, it did. And if I wanted to start some big trouble, I could come out with who it was. But I'm gonna keep it tucked away for a rainy day. And understand this. It doesn't matter what fake account you're using or if you're spoofing your IP, you can be traced. And lucky for her sister Samantha, she lives in the state of Florida. And Florida is my home state, and I can tell you we have a stand your ground law. You just don't mess with people. And at the end of everything, I know that she might have lashed out a couple of times towards Harry and Meghan, but that was only after Meghan allowed her dad to be made a fool of. And he did have two heart attacks, and she's a big fat liar that's been proven over and over again. She lied and said that he wasn't at her last wedding, and he has proven it with pictures. And it aggravates me that Meghan has sat back and allowed all of this abuse towards her family and to have her sister painted out as trash when she's anything but. Her sister went on and said that she's even been threatened and bullied when it came to her book, and that's just not fair. I wish the very best for Samantha and Thomas, and I cannot wait to read the book. I'll pay extra for a signed copy, Samantha. As for Meghan, karma is nipping at her heels. I'm afraid for Meghan before it's all said and done. She might find herself feeling a little bit unsafe. I'll see you soon and we'll talk fast. Y'all stay safe and be blessed.